aggregation. If class A owns class B, then class A is said to be aggregate class B. Class A is said to be aggregate class B. This is also commonly known as has a relationship. For example, customer has an address. For example, in our shopping app, a customer has an address. First, let's look at the customer class and address class independently. Customer class has an attribute like name, age, phone number. It has method like view details and update details. Address class has attributes like door number, street, area, and pin code. It has a method like update address. Let us look at the code of both the classes. Class customer has attributes, a name, age, phone number, and address has attributes like street number, door number, street, area, pin code, and it has a method update address. Here, those two methods are available, view details and update details. We want the customer class to aggregate the address class, thereby owning the address class and having full access to it. And the customer class must have an additional attribute for address as shown below. Look at this, a newly added attribute is the address. Just like customer has a name, customer has an age, customer has a phone number, now customer also has an address. In class diagram, aggregation is represented by a line connecting the classes and a diamond symbol in the class which aggregates. So customer aggregates address, so which aggregates the other class. In the above example, the customer aggregates the address and hence diamond symbol is near the customer class. Let us add the extra attribute in the customer class so that it can aggregate the address class as shown below. Look at this, self-driving address is additionally included. Now the other class that remains same, no difference you don't find, no change in this. Look at this, add one as an object, so it has address, it has a door number, street number, then pin code. Look at this, address one and address two, these two object has like this. Then customer has attributes like this, customer has a name, age and phone number, and address currently it is none. Customer two also address is currently none. Now connect both the classes. This is a customer class and this is address class. Now both are connected. Add one so and so, add two so and so. Then when it comes to customer class, when we initialize it, we say we pass name, age, phone number. We also pass an object, reference variable of address class. Then it is being assigned. Now class customer aggregates. This ensures that this add one is object one which we have included, that connects two classes. This is nothing but relationship, the aggregation. This ensures that class customer aggregates class address. Now try this out. Type customer one dot address dot door. Customer one is this, cust one dot address, it is here dot door. Door is nothing but 1 2 3. Like this you can access others as well. If you say customer two dot address dot street, so that gives us sixth line. You can try all combinations. Since the customer has aggregated the address class, since the customer class has aggregated the address class, the address object is available in the methods of customer class. Just like regular attributes, note, use code visualization to understand this code pattern. So we have this address as a parameter that is being passed when object is created. Here it has an address. Now we create address, we create two address objects, then we create customer object. When you create a customer object, we pass an address object as in parameter during the customer object creation. Then we try all that. Let's visualize this. Remember, the same aggregation relationship will be useful when you learn DBMS. So this is where we create address object. Two address objects instances are created. We're done with it. Two address instances are created. Now we are creating a customer instance. We know that customer instance attributes are, let's take a look at the customer instance attribute. It has name, age, phone number. This address, these attributes will have just value but this address will have an object. Reference variable itself we are passing. Add one we are passing here. Look at this. Jack 24, 1, 2, 3, 4, and add one we are passing. We are passing an object to this class. Object goes up. Four parameters. Look at this. Jack is just a variable value. 24 is a value. 1, 2, 3, 4 is a value. But address, it is pointing to an object. Our instance, all that are about to be assigned. Look at this. One by one, name is assigned, age is assigned, phone number is assigned, finally address. Now this address section is pointing to object instance one, address instance one. Then you try to view details and all that is easy. It's not a big thing to do. So self name, self age, self phone number. Then for address alone, what we do, self dot address dot door number, self dot address dot street, self dot address dot pin code. This is what you need to know. When you access direct members of the class customer, you can directly access it using self keyword. But when you access another class, the aggregated class attributes, we'll have to use this address. Self dot address is holding the object, so you'll have to access it like self dot address dot door number, self dot address dot street, self dot address dot pin code. This is how it needs to be accessed. That is a key takeaway from this. While updating address also, you can do self dot address equal to add. Add is pointing to another object. You can create another object and assign it. That is also possible. We have already seen that private variables cannot be accessed. Private data members cannot be accessed outside the class. This is true even in aggregation. The owning class cannot access the private attributes of the aggregated class directly. So in the previous example, we had a public attribute. Now what we have is private attribute, right? So to access that, how can we do that? So we need to have getter and setter as always. In this example, the first three values are printed, name, age and phone number. But when I was trying to access address, address dot self dot address dot door number, it is a private data member, you cannot access it. So we need to have getter and setter to access them. So it gives us error, address object has no attribute door number. Once we have appropriate accessor and mutator methods, we can start accessing the private variables of the aggregated class using those methods. Look at this example. We have get door number, get street, get pin code, again set door number, set street number, set pin code, all that we have. Now in this example, very address dot, instead of address dot double underscore door number, what you have done is we are using accessor, get door number, get street, get pin code. If you do that, you should be able to access it. Look at this, same example, but only changes, instead of directly accessing the private attribute, what we do is we are using getter, we are using accessor. So it is giving us the desired result. The circus manager wants to track the address of all the clones in the circus. Our programmer has come up with the two classes, address and clone. Help him to bring a has a relationship between the two classes. So the class, this is a clone and this is address. Address has attributes like address line, city, state, and the clone has attributes like name, self.name, then method get clone address. So then their access return self dot clone address, it is a private data member. So here it should be like this, self dot clone address is equal to clone address. It should be this. Choose the appropriate statement from the above options given. Consider clone's address to be private. What is the output of the following code snippet? Mobile has attribute like brand and case, and we have method display. It simply displays case dot color, then case must be an object because we have data, we use dot attribute. Then class case has an attribute like color. Now we say create an object c1 is equal to case of black, and this is called, and color currently is holding black. Then we call it again c2, currently c2 holds white. Then I will create mobile object, mobile of honey C1, the color we know that it is black. So it goes up, brand is updated to honey, and K case as a color of block. Right, it has attribute like a block. Right, fine. Then what we do is we update, using C1, we also update color is equal to green. It was having block, now after this line it will have block, green. So m1.display simply will display green color. What is the output of the following code snippet? It's simple, we have a class customer, class mobile and class cover. From here, we are creating an object for mobile first. So mobile, we pass Apple. Mobile goes up, brand is currently Apple. Then dot mobile dot unlock. Mobile dot unlock. Unlock is the method here. What I do was unlock of cover. So unlock of cover, we are trying to print cover dot cover value, color value. But if you look at this cover, the class cover has a private attribute. Trying to access a private attribute without muted accessor, you are simply trying to access it, that too, we are not using double underscore anything like that. So it will give us error. Look at this, it's the same class but different way. We are not using a private attribute now. The same way we are accessing, but what we say is in the line number 14 print statement, we are creating a new instance of cover. Cover is not this is not taken, but what we do is we are creating a new instance of color cover. So hence the changes whatever made in line number 13 right here, the changes whatever made in the line number 13 will not take effect on the new object. So you simply call them unlock. When you call this method unlock, initially it was red. When you do it here, it comes here, it updates here. Let's visualize this code to understand better. So we've taken class mobile and class cover instead. Now we are creating object, customer of, right? Customer has attribute like name, then has mobile object. And what the problem with mobile is, mobile has an attribute like brand. Mobile has only one attribute, that's fine. Then what we do is, then we call unlock method. In this mobile, we call unlock method. Right, that's what we do. It goes up, let's see what happens. One by one, we'll watch. And brand, mobile instance is created, brand value is updated. Fine, goes up. Customer instance created, name customer one, and that is the name of the customer. Then mobile is brand. Brand is actually, it is pointing to an object instance of the mobile class. It is not assigning any value. It is holding mobile instance as a passing a parameter. Then we call this method. Cover method is being called, and it has an attribute like color. It is assigned to red. Then finally it comes down. Then this also calls, after initializing it, this also calls unlock method. And what happens is this unlock method changes the color. Look at this, color red is being changed to yellow. This is fine. Now look at the last line, line number 14. What we do is we create new instance. Another instance is created, named as color red. So it creates a new instance, and that instance value is being printed. I hope you are able to understand this. Quick summary, classes can have relationship with other classes. In aggregation, one class owns another through, they have their own life cycle, though they have their own life cycle. Aggregation is represented using a diamond symbol in the class diagram.